This video will show you how to use the Water Measurement Interactive Map, or the WMIS map for short. To start the application, open up your browser and go to idwr.idaho.gov. Then, on the right-hand side, under Online Research, click on the Water Measurement Map. Click I agree on the disclaimer. Notice right away that the help documentation can be found by clicking on help. To get started with this application, either watch this video or go to the water measurement notes. There are different ways to navigate around this map. You can use the zoom in and zoom out buttons, or a very quick way to get to a specific area is to hold down the shift and then draw a box around the area of interest. If you find that your map is drawing fairly slowly, you can turn off the background. To do this, click on Change Layers and uncheck the box in front of Background. Also notice that in this area over here, the water measurement points are underneath a different layer. To put them on top, click on the bar with the water measurements and move it up to the top. To find the meaning of the different colored points and polygons on the map, again go to Change Layers, click on the dots at the end of the water measurement layer, and then choose View Legend to see what the different colors represent. To learn more about a specific water measurement point, simply click on it. Because I haven't zoomed in very closely, I have clicked on 13 different points. To scroll between the different records, use the arrow along the top. If you find that your map keeps shifting when you open up one of those pop-up boxes, make sure that you turn off your browser's pop-up blocker. The pop-up dialog box has quite a lot of information in it, including the measurements for the current site. If you would like to get more information about this particular WMIS number, click on the link. If you would like to export this data to a different file, you can highlight this information in the pop-up dialog box and then right-click, choose copy, and then paste it into a different application. If you would like to see this point on top of a different background, again, you can choose Change Layers, click on the drop-down to choose a background, and for example, choose the 2015 NAEP. Of course, don't forget to turn the background back on. You can change the transparency of the pop-up dialog box if you wish. You can do this by clicking on Options, click the drop-down next to Set Identify Window Transparency, and choose between Solid, Semi-Transparent, and Mostly Transparent. I will set mine back to Solid. If you note a specific WMIS number or metal tech number or the version name that you're interested in, you can search for those by clicking on Search, going to Select by Text String, setting the search layer to WMIS, and typing in the number. You will find the results underneath the Results tab. To zoom to this particular WMIS number, double-click on it. You can also specify multiple numbers, again by going to your search layer, specifying a field. For example, if you're looking for WMIS numbers, set the field to WMIS numbers. You can also choose for metal tag numbers, other metal tag numbers, or diversion names. Go ahead and type in the whole list of WMIS numbers you're interested in. All the queried features will appear underneath your Results tab. A third way to search for information about measurement devices in the WMIS database is to go to Select Features by Geometry, setting your search layer to WMIS, and click on the Select by Polygon tool. Draw a polygon on the map, double-click to finish, and it will show you information for all the measurement devices inside. You can download the WMIS site characteristics by clicking on the drop button. You can download the WMIS measurement summary data by clicking on the link icon. When you identify a WMIS point, notice that one of the attributes given to you is a spatial data ID. Let's assume that you are now interested in water rights information for the same area. Add this to the map by clicking on Change Layers, turning on the water rights, and changing the active layer from WMIS to points of diversions. Notice that some of the water right points are not covered up by water measurement points. To fix this, move the water rights layer to the top. Now when you identify this point again, it will give you the water right information. Notice that this also gives you a spatial data ID. If you want, this number can be used to relate the WMIS data to the water rights information. For more information about this specific water right, click on the link to the water right report. You can download the spatial data, like the WMS data, water rights data, and clip it to your area of interest and download it as an S3 shapefile, an S3 file to your database, or a Google KML file. To do this, click on Change Layers, click on Water Measurement to expand it, then click on the submenu button. Choose Clip and Download. Select the format of your download as either a shapefile, a file to your database, Google Earth. Select the area to clip. Do this by drawing an area around all the points that you're interested in. Double click to finish, and then open it in the application, for example, Google Earth. If at this point you also would like to see the groundwater district boundaries on Google Earth, go to the help documentation, copy, and paste this link into a new tab on your browser. If you choose either a shapefile or a geodatabase, it will create a zip file, save your file, unzip it, and then add it to ArcMap. Instead of selecting a specific area, you can also download an entire feature layer. To download an entire layer, again, go to Change Layers, choose the layer you wish to download, click on the submenu button, and choose Download Entire Layer. Alternatively, you can download those layers from IDWR's webpage. To do this, visit idwr.idaho.gov, hover over Maps and Spatial Data, and then click on Geographic Information Data. Do a search for WMS data, and download the data from here. Back in Help, you will have access to Water Measurement Notes, which covers the same information as this video, or you can go to the full manual, which has more information. For example, if you would like to add external layers to this WMS map, you can consult the full manual on instructions on how to do this. Thank you for watching this video.